As you look down over the water cube, time now for the Chevy Gold Medal Spotlight event. And it is Michael Phelps going for his 10th career Olympic gold medal in the men's 200 fly. You have a chance to witness rare history live here in Beijing. Phelps already with 11 career Olympic medals, 9 of them gold. He's the big favorite in this event, the world record holder. We expect not only the gold, but again, Phelps to continue a string of perfect races as far as world records go. So Paavo Nurmi, Larissa Latinina, Mark Spitz, Carl Lewis, the only four right now with 9 golds along with Phelps. He's trying to pass them all and stand alone in Olympic history. And it would be a shocker if he doesn't get it done. His mom, flanked by Michael's sisters, Hillary and Whitney, middle school principal Debbie Phelps, what news she could give the people back after the summer break. And Bob Bowman, who laid out the plan when Michael was 11 years old and told Michael's mom, you've got a special kind of athlete. And if we get through all the training sessions, he's going to do things that no one has ever done. Moss Burmester of New Zealand is in lane one. Actually trained with Phelps in high altitude in Colorado Springs. Wu Pong of China is in lane two. And he is going to hear the roars here. Lane three, Nikolai Skvortsov, bronze medalist at last year's World Championships. And he's right next to Phelps, who has not lost this race in 6 years. Takeshi Matsuda. Matsuda of Japan is in lane five. And then a familiar face, Hungary's Laszlo Cseh, bronze medalist in the 400 IM behind Phelps. Caio Almeida of Brazil is in lane seven. And in lane eight is Poland's Paweł Korzeniowski. Michael Phelps has broken the record 6 times in this event. He's also got another final later on, but right on his mind now is putting away career Olympic gold number 10, which would separate him from everybody else as the most decorated gold medalist in Olympic history.
Well, here he goes. It's going to look like a race early on and made it look like a race for about 150 meters. And then all of a sudden, he's going to make these guys all look like boys, Dan. And trust me, these are the best swimmers on the planet. They're not boys, but he will make them look like that.
Just to reiterate the exhaustive program for Phelps, 9th of 17 swims. He's got the second position right now behind Burmester of New Zealand in lane one. But Phelps, in that controlled manner, just gliding across the water.
Yeah, you're exactly right. That's what it looks like here. He's much more controlled than he was. You might remember in the 200 freestyle, he really jumped on that right away. And this time, he's really much more in control of himself. Still looking very strong, that first 100.
Phelps has the lead at the halfway point, just under world record pace, 9/100ths of a second. So he's 3 for 3 so far in Olympic golds, all of them coming with world records, hoping to keep the perfect streak alive.
Well, this is what you've got to watch. See how close it is? It looks like, oh my gosh, these guys might be able to catch him, but just watch and enjoy this last turn.
The turn for home and Olympic history for Michael Phelps, just ahead of the world record right now. Getting a little pressure from Burmester down at the bottom of the screen in lane one, but he's got the clear lead right now. 15 meters left for Michael Phelps. Career Olympic gold medal number 10 in his sights. He's going to stand alone in Olympic history. Is it going to be a world record? Yes! The greatest Olympic champion of all time tosses the goggles on the deck. Seventh time he's broken this world record.
I think he may be a little bit upset about that one, because I know he wanted to go 151. Hasn't talked about his times, but trust me, he wanted to go under that 152 barrier. I think that hurt him a lot more than he thought it would. Boy, you can look at the determination on his face. And look how relaxed it is. That's the key to fast swimming. Once your face starts to tighten up, the rest of the body will follow. What more can I say about this magical final turn? Maybe not the Michael turn that we're used to seeing, but he holds his breath that long. Just alone is miraculous. It's a constant awareness of where he's at. And then on the way home, he makes it once again look so easy.
So Phelps touches with his 25th career world record. And he'll continue the chase on Spitz, but he's also one individual world record away from tying Spitz. His mom, sisters, and other supporters watching it finally become a reality. Phelps will move back to the Baltimore area after these games are over. So Debbie will have her son, her little boy, back with her nearby. Let's listen to his coach, Bowman.
Bowman. He wants to write those splits down in a hurry.
And that was just kind of a casual toss of the cap and goggles on deck. Remember, Phelps has another final left. When he touched there, he was just about 54 minutes away from his next final, so we will not be asking Michael for an interview. He has to get to the cool down pool and warm up for yet another gold medal. So things going perfectly for Michael Phelps, Bob, right now here at theCUBE.